today, about one half of the world's population does not have access to internet. Imagine not having access to the knowledge database on the World Wide Web. Or imagine not having access to the tools or apps on our phones that help make our lives easier every day. For me personally, video conferencing through the internet is what has allowed me to connect with my family across the world in the Philippines. I am passionate about using my technical background as an aerospace engineer to find ways so that everyone can experience the opportunities provided by the internet. This is a map by Facebook Connectivity Lab showing internet connectivity throughout our world. You can see brightly lit areas in North America and Europe contrast against regions that are dimly lit or even in the dark in Asia, Africa, and South America. Not only do the populations in some of these dark regions lack access to internet, some of these populations may lack access to resources such as sufficient food, clean water, and education. Some research studies have shown that if we could provide these populations with access to internet, that they could rise out of poverty. Internet access can empower these populations by providing them with opportunities for education and for developing businesses. A child in a remote African village without schools can learn math, science, or programming by watching online tutorials. Or a merchant on a remote island in the Philippines can learn to develop an online website in order to sell his products to the online market and have an extra source of income to support his family. Some of you may have already heard of this solution of using internet access to help solve world poverty. However, have you actually heard of a practical solution of how we can connect 3.9 billion people around the world to the internet? Let me tell you, it is a significant technical challenge to connect the unconnected. So there have been two primary ways of providing internet access, both of which have limitations. The first method has been through fiber optic cables. This is a map showing fiber optic cables throughout our world. They are dug underground, undersea, or even strung on utility poles. Installing these cables can be significantly expensive, estimated to be between $20,000 to $40,000 per mile. There are also legal barriers, such as land rights, for where we can install these cables. Also consider that it may be impractical, if not impossible, to install these cables wherever we may need to connect people. The second method has been through communication satellites. These satellites typically lie in geostationary Earth orbit in space, and they provide internet to regions where they lie directly above. These satellites are comparable to about a 5-ton school bus. It is between tens to hundreds of millions of dollars to design and build these large satellites. And on top of that, $90 million to launch one of these satellites on a SpaceX Falcon 9. These satellites typically use what is known as radio frequency communication systems, or also known as RF. The limitation is that the frequencies in these types of systems are highly regulated. This is a chart of the United States frequency allocations. You can see that it is highly congested for typical satellite radio frequencies. Many of the major players in the industry already own the most ideal frequencies. So there has been an ongoing debate between which of these two platforms we should use to connect the unconnected: fiber optic cables in the ground or satellites in space. Or maybe a combination of two, but these have limitations. Why not find an alternative method that utilizes the advantages of each? Take the high performance of high-speed fiber optic communication and the ability of satellites to lie directly overhead regions of interest. This alternative method could be to utilize what is known as free space optical communication, also known as laser communication. Laser communication is a method of using light to carry data. This light transmits and propagates through free space rather than just inside of fiber optic cables. Laser communication offers several advantages over the radio frequency systems used on today's communication satellites. So if you have never heard of laser communication, I wouldn't be surprised if you're picturing red laser beams, like that from a laser pointer, shooting from satellites down through our sky. Although this is a great way to picture it artistically, this is not quite the case. The light from laser communication is actually not visible. It is in the near-infrared spectrum. Second, the light from an optical beam from a low Earth orbit satellite would actually spread to encompass a fraction of a city, not just a small dot you may see from a laser pointer. In comparison, a radio frequency signal would spread to encompass a portion of a continent or even a few countries. This presents the first advantage of laser communication, that the narrow optical beam can make it much more secure than radio frequency communication systems. However, there comes a challenge of pointing this precise beam. If the satellite and the laser communication were off, pointing this beam by even just 1 degree, it would completely miss the planet. The second advantage is that laser communication frequencies are currently not regulated. Laser communication uses much higher frequencies than the typical satellite radio frequencies. However, consider that clouds can block these higher frequencies, meaning that we have to be strategic in where we can apply laser communication. A third advantage is that laser communication can achieve much higher data rates than the radio frequency communications while reducing size, weight, and power. Let me give you a key example. So you can see NASA's Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter, also known as MRO. So MRO orbits around Mars, and its mission is to take high-resolution images of the Martian surface. One of these high-resolution images is comparable to about 7 HD movies, to put that into perspective. MRO uses a radio frequency communication system, and it transmits data back to Earth using that 10-foot-wide antenna that you see on top of the spacecraft. At a data rate of 6 megabits per second, it takes an hour and a half to send back just one image back to Earth. However, if we were to switch that system with a laser communication system, we would be able to send one of those images, or 7 HD movies, back to Earth in around just 5 minutes. At a data rate of 100 megabits per second. That is 17 times faster. And on top of that, we can get rid of that 10-foot-wide antenna you see on the top of the spacecraft and replace it with just a half-foot aperture telescope. You can see that laser communication can be quite a game changer. Laser communication has actually already been demonstrated in space. Between 2013 to 2014, NASA and MIT Lincoln Laboratory demonstrated laser communication from the LADEE spacecraft orbiting the moon all the way to Earth at a data rate of around 600 megabits per second. That's now 42 HD movies from the moon to Earth in around 5 minutes. And in 2008, the German Aerospace Center and TESAT demonstrated laser communication much closer to home, from a low Earth orbit satellite to Earth at 6 gigabits per second. Now we're talking around 420 HD movies from space to Earth in around 5 minutes. Based on the success of these laser communication demonstrations, even commercial industry has taken an interest. You may have heard both SpaceX and Telesat have proposed mega constellations of low Earth orbit satellites, with laser communication serving as the crosslinks. And now beyond commercial interest, other groups have found interest in using laser communication toward their mission to connect the unconnected, or also to better connect other populations. However, rather than using laser communication on satellite platforms, they found other creative platforms to utilize this technology. Google X had previous efforts of using laser communication between high-altitude balloons. And in current efforts through the Free Space Optical Communication Project, Google X is taking the same laser communication technology, but using it on the ground to help underconnected populations in India. You may have also heard how Facebook had previous efforts of using laser communication between high-altitude solar-powered drones. Based on the development of these technologies, you can see that laser communication is a viable technology to connect the unconnected, especially for people in very hard-to-reach places. Keep in mind that as we continue to connect people to the internet, we're providing them with life-changing opportunities. So join me as I continue to develop new technology, or as I find ways, alternative ways, to use existing technology to make the greater impact of connecting the unconnected.